Banana Laser! Lasers unite!
What's up, Banana Brains, and welcome to another Banana Laser commentary. My name is Matt, Wazelle if you're nasty, and with me, as always, is Dave Z. What the fuck is up, Dave Z?
Hey, yo, Suspiria! Finally! Ugh, I'm happy.
Dave is finally happy after years of doing Banana Laser.
Yes!
Finally happy.
We got ganked, and I'll explain later.
And he won't leave Alex Edwards.
Yeah, asshole, I'm still here.
And he's not happy about this.
This movie? No, I am. I just...
Okay, good.
I'm not as familiar as you guys.
No. And neither am I. And let me just say up front, I've got a little cold going on tonight, so I am flying high on some cold medicine, which I recommend that everyone out there who's watching this do, because it's probably the best way to watch Suspiria.
Wow. My arm hurts. I wonder if I should take some Vicodin.
Yeah, definitely. Crush them up and snort them.
Yeah, hold on. Let me go get some NyQuil real quick. I'm gonna.
You got some Tussin. Bust out the Tussin for this, guys.
Yeah,
it's gonna make it just that much better. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Hey, we really should do this. Wow.
All right.
So yeah, this is our commentary for Dario Argento's Suspiria, and we're watching the uncut version, which I guess you could call the director's cut, but it's uncut, uncensored. From the Anchor Bay release. Now, there is a couple issues with that. They've got some logos right up front. So what we've done is we've pressed play on the film, and we've paused it immediately as soon as a film by Dario Argento pops on the screen. So as soon as you see that on the screen, press pause, and I'm going to count down from five, and as soon as I say one...
Let me interrupt you, cause
son of a bitch.
Hold on. We don't want them to make the mistake of saying Salvatore Argento. A lot of people are going to look. It's a common mistake.
You mean
some of us have already done?
Maybe.
Yes. Okay, so let's walk you through it. You press play. It might have some logos. It might have some other shit. I don't know. But then it says, presented by Salvatore some Argento or something like that.
Uh-huh.
That's not
and
the
then,
one.
No, do not pause it there. And then it says, a film by Dario Argento. As soon as that pops on the screen, you press pause. Okay.
Good job.
Everybody on board. Good.
Yep.
Now, I'm going to count down from five. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. As soon as I say one, we all press play, and we're transported to a magical cold medicine land of witches. Okay.
Witch.
Here we go. All right. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Oh, I love it.
Yes. Classic score by the quotes goblins. It's the way they're credited in this film is very strange.
Right?
Is there a place I can find all their work?
The internet.
Do they have other albums? Like soundtrack?
So many.
Really?
So fucking many. Yes.
Eva Axon. Oh, yes. The voiceover that never returns.
Right.
It seems like this is a total add-on to get us into the groove, I guess, of the film.
Yeah, it's interesting. But I like it. It has a flavor. This movie has a flavor of its own, and it's just part of the charm.
Claudio?
There
diarrhea,
it is!
Diarrhea, cha-cha-cha.
Diarrhea, cha-cha-cha.
The Goblins. That's so weird, and it's in quotes. I guess this is maybe their first credit?
Maybe, I don't know. No, it's not, because they did...
Yeah, they've done shit before this.
Deep Red.
Yeah, this came out in 77? Yeah.
Yep.
Deep Red is older than that.
Did you ever see when you see Pink Floyd sometimes and it says The Pink Floyd?
Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah. I always wondered that.
Yeah, it's funny.
I'm going to go by the Matt Wazell. But put Wazell in quotes. Makes sense.
The Donald.
Every time I walk through an airport, I think about this movie and I put my headphones on and listen to the song.
And you imagine when the doors open and close, the music starts and stops like it does?
Yeah, especially when I'm on cold medicine, yes.
Oh, man.
Did you do that when he came to New Jersey to hang out with us?
Every time I go on a plane, I do it. Yeah, it makes life so much better for travel.
Yeah.
Just listen to a goblin?
A goblin and cold medicine.
Oh.
He likes some cool grape goodness.
Yeah, bust out the nasal spray. Come on, young lady covered in, you know, water. Who wouldn't pick that up?
A wet t-shirt.
Dude, the hardest rain ever is in the fucking the beginning of this movie. It's so hard.
Yeah, so am I.
Jessica Harper.
Ooh, I do love her in this movie.
She's very good.
Does seeing the McDonald's sign take you guys out of this movie for a second?
No.
Oh, fuck. Is this Italy? It's supposed to be Germany, but it looks like Italy.
Well, I was watching it this morning just as a refresher because I can never remember what happens in this film. And I was confused right away. Again, remember, I'm kind of sick. I was like, this is America? This looks so weird.
America.
Yeah. I thought she was in New York. I got it backwards. Like she's Italian going to New York, right? Oh, wait, no.
Well.
I'm such an idiot.
You're thinking of Inferno, the next movie.
Oh, right, yep.
Mm-hmm.
I can never remember what happens in that one either. That one's even more dreamlike.
Oh, that. Yeah. This is very easy for me. I could tell you the whole story in a minute, but Inferno, that's a whole other... Yeah, forget that.
Oh, we'll just do that, Dave, and we can short... You know, instead of an hour and 38 minutes, we can just hear you.
Are you kidding? I've waited so long for us to discuss this fucking movie because I love it so much. Ugh. And then...
What's the story you were trying to allude to earlier?
Oh, well... We were doing rolling through the 70s, and then the Great Banana Split came when our last show was 1976. And this was 77.
Dave is sharpening his knife over there. He's getting ready to stab me in the gut.
That was it. Because I got stabbed in the gut. That's why I was fucking... And I was in tears on that last recording, El Sweet Alice. It was really... It wasn't because of you guys... It was because I was waiting to do Suspiria all this time.
Oh, Lord.
2 years of podcasting on Banana Laser just to do one of my favorite movies ever, and the rug got pulled up from under me. So, yeah, that explains it all.
Wow.
Yeah.
Fuck.
I mean, come on, look. Look at this fucking this scene. Look at these shots.
Yeah, you can see the cameraman right there. His shadow.
Good
no,
eye.
You're right. This is a gorgeous film. I mean, there's no denying that. Anybody who says that is an idiot.
I mean, look at that. Holy fuck.
Does this film look better than Stitches?
That is a gorgeous film.
Beautiful.
And here's the location that will never leave the entire movie.
This Blu-ray looks great.
Yeah, we leave it. We go to a bar.
That's right.
Actually, we leave it shortly after here.
Turn the blue one! Turn the blue one!
Iris! Secret!
Yeah. I always like to do that once you know what they say in films. Right. Add it back in.
Right. Good call.
It's me, Susie Banyan. Susie Banyan, hello. I'm from New York. Well, maybe you shouldn't have got there at 10:40 at night or... 11 at night, or whatever it is. Jesus.
Right?
Man, yeah, she spent all day traveling, and now she can't even get into the place she's staying. That's fucking hell right there.
Oh, and the rain on top of mm-hmm. it? Fuck you.
Why didn't she just go in while the other girl was going out?
Yeah, she didn't even try the door. Miss Bannon, you're an idiot.
I love this shot. Holy fuck. Okay.
Witch. listeners, take a drink every time Dave says, "I fucking love this shot." You're going to be drunk in 30 minutes.
Boom. You see, now, this is a different place. This is not the school. This is somewhere else entirely.
Oh, yeah.
It's a common misconception, actually.
Oh, fuck. Yeah. You're right. I always thought this was the same place. Like, she just kind of, like, went back.
Yeah, this girl goes to a friend's, like, apartment, I guess.
It looks like blood's about to get off the elevator.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's right. I think I've seen this film maybe 6 times. It's probably my 6th viewing. And I didn't see it until, I want to say, 2004. It's the first time I watched it.
Wow. That's crazy.
What about you, Dave? When did you first see it?
I saw it in the 80s because it was at the time we were renting everything. And I was introduced to it because it wasn't actually at any of the video stores, but in the back of Fangoria magazine, there was an ad for it. And it said, what did they call it? Not widescreen. They called it the, give me a second. Oh, shit. What's that called? Letterbox. No, Letterbox.
Yeah.
It said the Letterbox edition of Dario Argento's Suspiria, and it was pimped up. I don't know what it said, but my friend and I, who we used to always rent movies, we were so jazzed about it because of the ad, and so it was like $90. So we combined our money and we ordered it for fucking $90, and then then it arrived and we watched it, and it blew
and
us away.
You guys fought over it like it was Radioactive Man number one.
So you paid $90 for as a blind buy?
Yes.
That's awesome.
I know.
In 1980? And look at this. That's worth, like, nothing. Dave won't spend that much money in a blind buy for, like, an $8 movie at Walmart.
You're right. It's true. I won't.
Hey, when you're a kid, things are much different.
Yeah, it was much more exciting to see a movie that you never saw before back then. Wow. It had a reputation, is what it was. It was just like, you know, the ad sold us, basically. You know? It's like,
yeah, that's cool.
Yeah. And I had no idea what to expect, and I just loved it for the kills and the shit. And it took years for me to appreciate it on a technical level like I do now. Like, now it just blows me away because of the soundtrack and you know, the colors and the visuals. Back then, I was just like, wow, great kills, awesome movie, you know?
Yep.
Yeah, it's come full circle with me now.
Well, even back then, it was, I guess, a big deal to appreciate the look and the shots and everything, because if they bothered to make it letterbox in the 80s, then it must have been a big deal to see, like, preserve how it was shot, you know, even on home VHS video.
Yeah, it makes total sense. Just at the time, we were just like, wow, this is the ultimate version of this amazing movie that we've never seen. Let's get it, you know?
Yeah. And that was a VHS? Not a Laserdisc?
Nope, it was a VHS. Yep.
Wow, crazy.
Yeah. Well, back then, that's how much they cost, remember?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. That shit was expensive, yeah.
Yeah, remember everyone was afraid? Like, if you rented movies, like, if you lost a movie, it was like an $80 charge or something.
Yep.
It's so funny nowadays.
Matt used to rent his VHS player.
Yeah. Yeah, at least twice in my life, I remember my mom rented a whole player before we actually owned one.
Those were the days.
Look out, lady. There's a guy with really hairy arms out there. Like, freakish. Like, it's the Wolfman.
And it's not even a guy. That's the scary part.
Oh, do we definitively know who this killer is?
No, I'm just teasing because they're witches. Oh, you know.
I got you.
No,
if you saw those eyes, would you stay near the window?
No.
Yeah, I wonder if she actually saw them. She didn't like react. And now this hair—that's makeup, right? To look crazy. It's not like this is a hairy person.
They're Italian. You don't know.
That's true. Hairy motherfuckers.
Yeah, we're hairy people.
Oh. You know why Italians wear gold chains around their neck? So they know where to stop shaving.
Oh, shit.
Didn't I just say I was Italian?
Oh, shit. Damn.
Oh, well, listen, do you want to go find the body or not?
Awesome. What a perfect callback, because that's the guy that I play in the skit.
Hey. Oh, by the way, guys, my dog is prying.
Oh.
Don't say that. This is
stabbing
my favorite
her
kill.
Is not enough. No. Yeah, it's like, gotta do more.
My favorite kill of any horror movie, this whole sequence.
Really?
Absolutely. Everything about it's amazing.
He just will not stop, and she is still alive. Look at that. Right in the heart. That's amazing stuff.
Man.
Oh, and so, yeah, okay.
It's a double kill.
Oh, he killed her by accident?
Which adds to it. Oh. Damn.
Well, that's going to ruin her weekend. Wow. There's bright blood that Alex loves.
Yep.
I was saying, yeah. They must be making a mess painting that room.
I totally prefer it.
Double homicide.
So ooh, right in the cooch.
Fucking cool.
Oh yeah. God.
Come on now.
That's going to leave a mark.
Ah. Fucking fantastic. And here we go.
Look at this guy.
This fucking asshole.
Asshole. I love this guy.
I know.
He's great.
His death scene later is probably one of my favorites.
Awesome.
Spoiler alert.
I was going to say, now I know he dies.
Oh, guys, so I'm sorry. If you haven't seen this film and this is the first time watching it, you should turn it off and watch the film first. Because we're going to spoil it. Okay, Whew. Thank God I said that.
I haven't seen it in 39 years. What's wrong with you?
I believe that's the first time we've given a spoiler warning on a commentary.
I think maybe I did it one other time. It's always just funny to me how people still say it. It's like, duh. It's like telling people how to leave a voicemail. Okay, you can stop already.
Yeah.
Okay, there's going to be a beep coming up. All right, when you hear that beep, don't get scared. That's normal. Leave a message, and I can listen to it at a later point.
Yeah. You got to be cool like Dylan in 90210 who just said, you know what
to
do.
Leave a message, sucker. Oh, he did a few of them. He did a few of them. One of them was leave a message, sucker, in season 5. What was the one you know?
Dylan, when he just said, you know what to do.
You know, because
he's the coolest fucking character ever.
Yep.
Heroin or not. He's the only guy that could be so cool. He could be a junkie and still be cool.
Yeah.
Man.
Yep.
Yeah, she's definitely not evil.
Look at her hair. She looks like that guy who was leaning out of the door when Dorothy was crying about not getting to see the wizard.
Not no way. Not no how.
Oh, shit.
That's right. That's awesome.
Oh.
We should do a commentary on The Wizard of Oz.
Matt, will you watch that movie or no?
Wizard of Oz?
Yeah, there's midgets in it.
One of my favorite movies of all time.
Oh, you don't care about the midgets being in it?
No. They're munchkins. They're not midgets. They're different.
Oh, I'm sorry. Okay, so Oompa Loompas are okay too then?
Yeah, they're fine.
Okay. Ooh, here she comes.
We should start calling midgets munchkin.
Oh, yeah, they love that. Or elves. Call them elves. There you go.
Remember when that guy called that one guy an elf in the movie Elf? That was so funny. He goes, look, it's one of Santa's elves. He goes, yeah, we're all dying over here. Real funny.
Say elf one more time, buddy boy. Yeah, it's a good scene.
That was great.
So these all are set pieces, which is pretty fucking crazy. They built all these things for this movie because no place looks like this, you know?
Huh.
Yeah, you think there's really places that look like this, all blue and all red and shit like that? No way.
Well, in Europe, maybe. I don't fucking know. In Europe in the 70s? Who the fuck knows?
Yeah, that's true. I can't say for certain it's a set piece, but I envision that it is.
It would make sense for a filming standpoint.
Yeah.
Everything's too contemporary now. We don't have stuff like where people try to do thought-provoking imagery and architecture anymore.
And when you do, people will get pissed off and say, oh, it's all style over substance, and it's a piece of shit movie because of that, you know?
Mm-hmm. Oh, you must be talking about The Witch.
Sure, The Neon Demon, The Witch, this, yeah. Tons of movies, you know?
Yep.
Just because there's more style than substance doesn't mean that there's no substance.
Right.
This guy.
Want some fucking tea?
Those first.
See my fucking teeth. I got teeth now.
I used to work with a guy at the casino. Looked just like him.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah.
Was he mute?
No, actually, he couldn't shut the fuck up.
Oh, fuck that guy.
Quite the opposite, right? Oh, here we go. Here's the cats. Squawk, squawk, squawk. I fucking love Olga. Oh, God, she's so hot.
Is that the one that says the names of snakes?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yep. Oh, I love her.
Olga.
So, how old are these women?
20s?
20? Yeah.
Yeah, it's a dance academy, so it's got to be after high school and when, you know, this is their college, I guess, you know?
Well, I read in the original draft it was supposed to be like 13-year-olds.
Damn.
Yeah.
That would have been fucked up.
Yeah, can you imagine seeing them getting brutally stabbed and shit?
Yeah, but if it was, this scene would have been so much hotter.
Oh, fuck yeah, I would have fucked all of them.
Is that Olga?
That's her.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah,
she's hot.
Jessica Harper, has she been in any other horror films that are known?
Not horror, I do not think so, no.
Okay.
She's a doll, too. I like her. I like her big eyes in this movie. Mm-hmm. I don't know. She's just adorable.
Yeah, I've seen her in stuff to this day. I just can't think of it.
Man, she's going to be on that check.
Yeah, she is. Whoa. Honk, honk.
The nose hit the camera when she turned around.
Cut. Cut.
No. Just keep rolling. Come on. She does this every scene. Man, they keep showing her too. Every angle of this room so far, that nose has been there.
Yeah, she's got like Princess Leia wannabe hair.
Totally.
It's like in weird buns.
Now wait a minute, what year is this? Because wasn't Star Wars 77?
Yep. Yeah, this is 77 as well.
Wow.
That was the end style, I guess. Buns,
I guess.
Hey, she's painting her nails with blood. What the fuck?
Those are Halloween nails.
Yeah.
Look at that hair. Jesus.
Yeah, dude. Straight up Leia.
Oh, my God. That wallpaper is making me fucking dizzy.
Oh, I love it.
That is so busy. That's nuts.
Yeah.
It's fucking trippy. I can get lost in that wallpaper, I think.
What is that thing in the back? Is that a table? Looks like an hourglass. Is that a light? What?
I hope it's a light.
Yeah. Looks like, oh, they gotta turn it over to time shit.
Yeah, it's the fuck. It's more Wizard of Oz shit. It's a witch. There you go. See, you have until the sands run out.
Oh yeah! Wow.
Oh wow! Is there flying monkeys in this?
Yes. You go. The hairy arm in the beginning. He's a flying monkey.
Holy shit! Is this guy the Scarecrow? Because he looks like he's fucking dope.
Yeah, it looks like he doesn't have a brain.
Yeah.
It's weird how we accidentally, like, brought up a bunch of witch movies. Like, you said The Witch, I said Wizard of Oz.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
That's weird. Now we have to talk about, like, Lords of Salem or something.
No. Nobody wants to talk about that.
Let's compare the shots and see if he got anything from Argento.
Oh, brother.
Oh, he did. Next season. Next season, we'll do Lords of Salem.
Okay.
Right, Matt?
Like, I didn't sign up for another season.
Matt's been ducking that one for years.
Lords of Salem?
Yep.
Hey, I was on Skeleton Crew talking about it a little bit.
Yeah, that was your first show.
Yeah, and I was like, it sucked.
Oh, yeah, you shit on it. You pulled down your pants and fucking took a stinky, steamy turd all over it.
Big time.
Yep, and then picked it as your number 13 horror movie of the year.
Well, because... You know why? Because that was like the limit of horror films I actually watched that year.
By default, right?
Yeah.
Like, when by default? 14.
Since we're picking 13 movies.
Is that all I watched?
Oh, shit.
Oh, man. Queen Amidala's looking pretty hot.
Right?
I will not condone action that would lead us into war.
I wish I could remember things exactly as they happen. Look at that. Like, I can't. If you ask me, like. Yeah.
I just love that. I mean, it makes no sense, but it's in, like, all these Italian films, especially Argento. It's like, if you just keep thinking about it, you might be able to remember what you didn't actually notice the first time.
Wouldn't it be, like. What? It's what?
The subconscious thing, I think.
Right.
Wouldn't it be more artistic? Like, I'm sure we would do this if we were filmmakers. And I'm not knocking anyone else, because, you know, I'm nobody with this. But if we, let's just say there was a scene of a movie, right? And somebody was somewhere, and, you know, the character who's trying to remember was in the shot. If they were going to do a flashback, like, just then, and they were trying to remember the person at the door, wouldn't it be cooler, and wouldn't you change, like, film it at that time a different way and have it from the point of view of the actual character who's trying to remember it? So you could see their vision of that memory instead of the movie you just watched?
Yeah.
Makes sense.
Yeah. No, yeah. Absolutely makes sense.
Like, that'd be cooler.
Like, she's, yeah, you see her vision and it's the memory, or it's the movie.
Yeah.
It's like, you're watching the same movie as we are?
Yeah, right.
So how about this? This situation here. I think this is fucking, this woman wants to move her into this place to have her under her spell. And she's like, nah, fuck you. I don't care if the room is free. I want to stay with Olga. Right. That's what I got out of it, that Madame Blanc wants to get her in there for that reason, you know?
Yeah. Yeah, that's her motive, right?
Yeah.
But then she applauds her for being strong.
Well, that's the power struggle, because Madame Blanc is in charge, and she's not in charge, and I think it's like a, you know, good for you for sticking up to that bitch, even though she's our leader, kind of.
Madame Blankenship?
On Halloween night, yes.
You know what happened? Witches.
That's right. Oh, I love this part.
Yeah. What's up, baby?
Witch.
That kid should be in more scenes because he looks fucked up.
Is that Anakin Skywalker?
Yeah.
That was a
know who he reminds me of? The Dutch boy on the cover of The Paint.
Oh my god. Okay, so this is the thing that makes her lightheaded and gives her a nosebleed later?
Yes.
That reflection?
Yeah, she's fucking with her. Yeah, they're all witches. I mean, it's a coven. They can do what they want, apparently.
So what's their ultimate goal? To just kill everyone? I don't...
To rule what is the their world. Goal?
Yeah.
Their goal is to run a successful business as a front for their coven. And this girl here is coming in, ruffling feathers right away, so they're fucking with her.
Ah, okay, so that's because she doesn't want to live there, so they're like, okay, we're going to put you in a trance, make you have to stay here.
Yes.
Okay. Man, so good to watch this with Dave Z. Yeah.
Here to help. Look at, isn't that Ashton Kutcher? Do you see him?
We're being punked.
Oh, fuck.
Entertainment Weekly calls this one of the scariest movies of all time. Would you say that, Dave?
Scary? I mean, it could be scary. I just... This depends on your frame of mind. But when I think about scary... Pardon me. When I think about Suspiria, I don't think about scary. I'll admit that.
When you think of scary, do you think about Suspiria?
Yes!
Not really. No. There are scary moments, though. You know?
This is scary.
There he is, Ashton. Totally, man. Look at him.
Jesus.
And one. And two.
He got stuck there trying to find his car.
That's the butterfly dance.
Hey,
and then he's the butterfly effect. It's weird, huh? Nobody really gives that movie credit. I think that's an amazing movie.
Agreed.
I used to love it, and then I watched it a bunch. It's like Donnie Darko. I used to love that film, and then I watched it like 10, 12 times.
Right.
And then it's like, wait, this whole thing just kind of falls. It just falls apart too much for me to enjoy it. Yeah, unfortunately. Oh.
Really?
Well, then I guess I'll just leave it as a memory, so that don't happen to me.
Yeah, please. Yeah, don't watch it a lot because that's what ruined it for me. Because you know I love time travel and all that shit. So
yeah.
Oh, true. Right. So you're gonna pick that one apart? Jeez, every fucking time travel movie you can pick apart. Shit.
Oh no, you definitely can, but it's not just the time travel aspect of it. It's the there's just so much other things that just don't make sense.
What about the pedophilia?
That was really good.
Yeah, you should like
Eric
that.
Eric Stoltz? Yeah. Oh, I loved it. I wish we got to see him rape that little boy, yeah.
Yeah, but I want him to do it in Rocky face.
Oh, this part makes me wince more than anything in the movie.
To be forced water?
Just the glass going up against her teeth like that? Oh, fuck.
Oh, yeah.
The noise it makes? I don't like it.
Yeah, they couldn't get a smaller glass? Like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
Were you ever so drunk you banged a beer bottle on your teeth?
Oh, probably.
I was so drunk I banged a beer can, but my dick got cut when I was trying to get it in the hole.
Good boy. So you got it in the hole, though, right?
just the head, and it cut it up, and I said, okay, it's enough.
Yeah, it was the wide mouth can.
Right.
Yeah, less glug or
cores. Yes.
Yeah. Remember when they used to, was it Miller Lite that used
I think
to
it was
let
Miller.
You... No, that used to let you pop a hole in the can.
Oh, like, Jesus, yeah. To let air through.
Yeah, they got rid of that really fast.
Yeah, it's like encouraging you to slam beers. Like, can't get drunk fast enough?
Yeah, they just got rid of that.
Oh, go ahead.
No, I was going to say, I was even starting to pop them on a regular basis just because it was there.
Yeah, even though you just, probably didn't give a shit.
No.
One of the taglines I find strange for this movie is the only thing more terrifying than the last 12 minutes of this film are the first 92. So what they're saying is the first 92 minutes are better than the last 12. It's like once they wrote that, they didn't think about what that actually meant.
And you want to know what? That's the tagline that sold us on buying the VHS.
Yeah.
So it worked. But in retrospect, you're right. It's saying that the climax isn't really that good.
It isn't as good as the first 92 minutes. So we're watching the best part right now. We'll just turn it off.
Yeah, I don't think they thought that went through.
No.
Let's look at when there's 12 minutes left and see.
Yeah, see if it gets worse.
Yeah, it's probably that moment where she's, yeah, figuring out the footsteps and going through the corridors, probably.
Which I've grown to love, but funny thing is, my one complaint about this movie for years is that it's kind of anticlimactic the way it suddenly ends. It's like, I always thought it was a little bit easy the way, you know, she kills the witch. But yeah. I've learned to love it. I've learned to love it now, but for a while that was my only complaint.
Yeah. I didn't mind it. Or I don't mind it. Hey, Teeth.
Should we call Dr. him
Jaws?
Teeth.
Jaws from fuck. James Bond?
Yeah.
He even looks like him, kind of.
Yes. He could be a stunt double, totally.
You idiots. You captured their stunt doubles. Spaceballs.
Oh, yeah.
That's, man, that's not enough wine.
I know, right? Holy fuck. It's like a Jesus. Half a bottle.
Fill that glass. Jesus.
Wow, here, I never
your
noticed.
Daily wine.
Shit. For
here's the your first daily time. Gallon of wine.
Right? Jesus. No, for the first time I noticed in the hallway, I love that light there, but I just saw that in the hallway, the window was the same window, very similar to the one that the girl goes through in the beginning scene. The color and the way it looked. It's too late now, but it just stuck out to me now, which is odd.
Let's stop it.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, that's why that is confusing, because the buildings are so eclectic that it's hard to believe that that opening murder scene isn't actually in this building.
Maybe it's like a dorm for the school. Like it's still part of, it's like run by the school.
It's on the campus. It's just a little ways away.
Yeah. I don't know. That's the best I got.
This part I never really understood. I mean, yeah, it's a witch thing, I guess, but...
I think it's happenstance.
Oh, okay.
I think it's the truth, because when they go up there, you see the fruit, and it's riding on the fruit. Ugh, gross. Ugh,
yeah, that is
fuck.
Pretty gnarly.
Oh, man. Fuck you.
They're going to turn into little Jeff Goldblums.
See the window?
Yeah, you're right. Same color scheme. Yeah. Dude, gnarly.
It's fucking sick.
It was you, wasn't it, Ashton? We've been punked! Ha, maggots! Look, there's a camera there. There's a camera there. We're on MTV.
Oh, shit.
Oh, this is okay then.
Yeah, oh. Mm. That makes you putting insects all over me fine.
Oh, man, that blue is so cool.
Man, I'm drunk from listening to today.
The blues, the reds. I know. See, this is a genuine thing here. This has nothing to do with any witchery or anything taking place at the school. It's just she explains it later that they got sent bad fruit or some shit like that.
Is it against... Would they still let you crush a bunch of maggots in a movie, or would they say that's
Yeah, I think today they wouldn't let you do that, actually.
You think PETA defends maggots?
Yeah, I 100% do, yeah.
I don't know.
It's like you can't do it with cockroaches.
Right, you can't.
Even though they're fucking disgusting, vile things. Ugh.
What about maggots? Fuck. What's worse? What would you rather wake up to?
Cockroach.
Cockroaches or maggots?
Cockroach.
Cockroach is the worst thing ever.
Yeah, but maggots, dude, because if there's one, there's a bunch more wherever you are.
Oh, God.
Yeah, but you can get away from a maggot. A cockroach? Some of those fuckers can fly.
Right.
I mean, it would be gross because they'd be crawling on you when they have legs and shit. Gross.
Ugh, yes.
But maggots.
I used to hang out with somebody who had a roach problem, and I'll never forget watching something, man. And one of those goddamn things were crawling on my arm when I was sitting on the couch.
Oh,
I could not, dude. I couldn't jump fast enough, man.
Fuck that! I would never go over there.
Hey, Matt.
This is Revenge of the Nerds all over again.
You just read my mind. I was just about to ask you. Holy fuck!
Look out for that basketball and the chili.
Yes. I knew you would think of it because I think of it every time ever since Revenge of the Nerds. Yeah. Amazing. Any second now, fucking Point Dexter's gonna walk in. Oh shit, you gonna eat that? Booger's gonna fucking take food off of him. Oh shit, that's amazing. You actually read my, I was just about to, when I said, hey man, my next words were, does this remind you of Revenge of the Nerds?
Hell yeah.
Awesome.
God, I wonder if I would have watched that film as much as I did if it didn't have all the nudity.
Yes, enough personality.
Yeah, it definitely has that. Yeah, you're right. But the nudity was such a huge draw when you're six or whatever.
Buddy Childs? Oh my god. Yeah.
Are all the sequels good?
No. Part two is tolerable.
Yes.
And then everything after that is made for TV. The 3 and 4, I think, are made for TV.
What about, like, all the Porkies?
Those are actually pretty good all the way through.
Yeah. I would say. Matter of fact, Porky's 3, Porky's Revenge, is better than Part 2 was.
Well, yeah. It's like Part 1, but amped up, because Part 2 literally has nothing to do with the titular Porky character. Yeah.
Yes. They brought Porky back for part 3, and they brought the whole...
Yeah. It's Porky's Revenge.
Yes.
It's like Revenge of the Sith in the Porky's universe, definitely.
Oh, shit. Okay, Porky's Revenge or the Revenge of Michael Myers?
What about the Ghost of Porky's?
Yeah, Porky's
meets
film.
The Wolfman.
Porky meets the Wolfman.
And the Porky's, and the Ghost of Porky's, the big thing is that Porky ultimately gets destroyed by a red bucket.
Red bucket. You know what's so funny about that? I never thought it through for a second. I was gonna hit him, and I just picked that up. Like I even, it's so weird how that came to be.
The best things are organic, man. Straight up.
Yeah.
Right. Okay. So the witch... So, you know, Mater is here. You know? The mother of Scythe, Mater Suspirium, is fucking here.
The witch that's at the end of the film?
Yes. Now, so are they... Because of the maggots... Are they saying that they had to move everybody here because of that? So, in other words, is she always here? She would have to be, right?
Meaning she always lives in the school?
Correct.
Yeah, I think so.
Because they make it sound like, you know, because the girl tells a story now saying one time the headmistress was here and, you know, she was here for a week. But apparently she must always just live there because where else could she live?
Right.
Elena Marcos! See, this movie here and Halloween are two movies that, if you take the soundtrack out, they're nowhere near as effective.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, who's better, John Carpenter or Goblin?
Well,
shit,
it's tough.
Yeah, it is tough. Yeah.
I don't think Carpenter's stuff is as complex, right?
Well, yeah, that's possibly true. But they both have hills and valleys, because not all Goblin is great.
I agree. Right. Want to know something weird? John Carpenter basically riffed off of fucking Deep Red to do his Halloween theme, and he admits to it.
Really?
Yeah, matter of fact, the Skeleton Crew intro with that sped up version of the song from Deep Red. If you think about it, that composition is very familiar to the Halloween composition.
What are you talking about?
Oh yeah, you're right. Yeah.
We don't have a Deep Red song.
Yeah, shoot, you don't even know what you have on your own fucking show.
What? Wait, what do you mean? What's Deep Red?
We had this discussion like a week ago, actually.
Oh, the thing Matt played in the beginning of the Halloween, that's Deep Red?
Think about it.
It's a remix version.
Think about that song, Alex.
Just take out the hip-hop beat.
Right.
Right.
Hey, Matt, can you make us a new intro?
No, it's like, I don't want to be associated with Diarrhea Gento.
Wow, Deep Red. So what were you thinking when you heard that, Dave? You were probably glad, right?
Yeah, I loved it. Yeah.
Yeah.
Did you just say Diarrhea Gento?
Yep.
Interesting. Ooh. So a gentleman that has diarrhea. Okay. This is great. This whole sequence is probably the only comedy of the movie. How upset she gets in the whole scene with the dog. I think it's hysterical. Get out!
I watched this movie this morning and I've already forgotten.
Well, when she throws the blind man out when they have the fight because the dog bites the kid. See, look how pissed off she is.
Matt, are you going to wallpaper your new house like this?
No, I'm actually going to make it like the cabin place from Twin Peaks.
Are you really?
Ooh.
No.
Ooh.
You should do like what you always wanted to do in your house. You should make it look like something that you love.
The inside of the Millennium Falcon? Check.
Chewy. Wormhole. Yeah.
You should get a big like mannequin and put Chewy stuff on him. That'd be cool.
Well, Matt's tall. He can be Chewy. I can come in. Yeah. I can be Han Solo. How's that?
There we go. Perfect. Who's Alex going to be?
Luke Skywalker, of course.
Hell yeah. Yeah, I need stop that hand. It.
Yes.
That stop it was used, I think, in a ministry song.
Stop it!
Or he hasn't said it yet. He has it, yeah. That right there, yeah.
Yep. it ends that one song, right.
Yeah, I forget what song it is.
Oh, I know what song. Psalm 69.
Okay.
Yep, 69. Yeah, that's how it ends.
That group is big on samples, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I'm blind, not deaf.
Yeah.
Do they use, "There is no tomorrow" from Apollo?
They should.
Somebody else I heard did. There is no it was like Pee-wee Herman saying there is no tomorrow, that version.
You're such a jerk, man. There is no tomorrow.
Oh fuck.
Here's your breakfast wine. Wine for breakfast? What is this place? I guess I'm in Europe.
Indeed.
He's Lurch.
Yeah.
Lurch.
You rang or some shit?
You rang. Yes, Lurch. Go and get the newspaper.
Gulp. Gulp. Gulp.
Damn.
You have to drink living there.
Right?
That reminds me, I need some more NyQuil. I'm starting to lose my buzz.
Well, there is no better horror movie to watch fucking on a buzz than this movie, I don't think. It's just my opinion, of course, but I feel strongly about it. It's the most tripped out fucking horror movie there is.
Matt, were you getting high on dexomorphin or something? Is that the active ingredient?
I don't know. I would have to go get it. Is that DM?
Yeah.
I don't know if what I'm taking has that in it, actually. But anytime I take any cold medicine, it doesn't matter. I feel like I'm having an out-of-body experience for the most of it. It's crazy. The shit reacts to me so strangely. I don't know if everybody does that.
That's why we take it. Getting healthier is just like a side effect to getting high.
More cold medicine, Matt? I got a runny nose, goddamn it.
You may as well make the most of it.
Exactly.
Yeah, if you're sick, just fucking stay in bed. Take as much dope as you can, you know, prescribed or over the counter, whatever, and watch fucking movies like Suspiria and shit like that.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. At least
enjoy yourself if you can, shit.
Dave, you should, when you get your new house, you should have lights that are like all these kinds of colors in it.
Yeah, if I get my room, I definitely will. I'll try it. We'll see what we can do. You can do it now. Why don't you do it? Oh, okay. Cool.
I could prove it to you right now if you want.
I believe you. I mean,
we're in the same room, but I mean later.
Yeah. When
right now, my room is exactly the color of that background of her that we just saw. Yeah.
The red?
Right now, I'm looking to my left and I see exactly the same things. Yeah.
Damn.
It's that's awesome. Matt did that in college.
Well, technically, I never went to college, but.
Huh. Yeah, but you went to a college and did it there.
Yeah.
No, I did it at the age that I would have been in college.
18 to 22.
Yeah, there you go.
There you go. Yeah, you know what? I did the same.
In my bathroom, lights. I did it.
Your bathroom? Mm-hmm. Nice.
The bathroom had, like, a mirror, and then it had maybe five or six bulbs at the top of the mirror, all exposed, and so I did it there.
Wow.
So you put, like, those black light bulbs there?
I don't know if I ever did that, but colored definitely lights? Color bulbs, yeah.
Nice.
Because how when you're tripping, you want to go into the bathroom, look in the mirror for about 4 hours.
That's just what I want to do, yeah.
Yep.
Look in the fucking mirror, yeah.
You go inside your mind, it's fucking insane, yeah.
Yeah, fucking see Satan, okay.
Oh my God, I feel like I'm watching the Griswold's Vacation.
Hey, weren't these guys in Home Alone, I think? John Candy's traveling band or some bullshit? I don't fucking
know. Oh, yeah, Home Alone.
The polka band?
Polka, polka. He was so annoying when he kept naming all the different kinds of polka. I was like, dude,
you can broil it, saute it, grill it.
Polka shrimp, polka scampi. That guy looks like one of the Blues Brothers she's taken out of there.
Elwood?
Yeah. They just start smacking each other.
I love this scene because it's so drawn out. And it's like, okay, where's the threat coming? It's coming, right? The threat's coming? And then when it finally comes, it's like, oh, fuck. You kind of almost forget.
Yeah, it's well played. Exactly. Mm-hmm. You think it's coming from all different places. They even go as far as they have flapping wings fucking approaching the guy,
Oh, speaking of flapping wings, I cannot wait till that bat comes later.
Oh, that fucking big bat? Yeah.
That's hilarious. Yeah.
Yeah, that's classic.
I just like this setting. I don't. It looks so cool and ancient. Like, that's just a street that you can fucking walk down wherever they are. It's awesome.
Yeah, yeah, you're right. This is really drawn out. I'm losing my buzz during it.
Got to re-up.
Yeah. Hold on. All right. I'm back.
Fucking Nanook smells a vampire.
Nanook.
Oh, shit.
We're the Frog Brothers when you need them.
Bloodsucker!
Man. Imagine having to walk through this every night.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
You know? Too bad he's blind. He can't see it.
He can't even appreciate it. He might as well be all going down an alleyway somewhere.
Hey, here's a real question. How does he know when he's done wiping his ass?
He probably sniffs the toilet paper.
Oh, got it.
How does he know if he's pissing into the toilet bowl or on the, like, if he's missing? He probably has to sit down and bitch it.
Well, I would. There's no question. Why even take the chance?
Right.
Yeah, exactly.
I don't mind sitting down. Fuck it. Who gives a shit?
I know. Fuck.
It's not a slur on my manhood. What the fuck do I care?
Dude, are you kidding me? When I used to be like totally like messed up drunk, and I used to crawl to the bathroom at 2 in the morning, you think I was standing there?
Oh, yeah. Please. No.
Fuck no. Sit down.
I was like, yeah, whatever. F off. I'm sitting down.
Who gives a shit?
Is he looking at that eagle up there?
See here.
The flyby.
I wear my sunglasses at night, so I can't see anything anyway.
Looks like a kitchen tile, doesn't it?
What?
A kitchen tile that he's standing on.
Oh. That's
what it looks like. Like from afar? Did you ever see like a kitchen tile from like the 80s? I don't know.
No, I was born in 1990.
Oh, shit.
I'm a millennial. I don't know. Uh-huh. What's a millennial if you're like 20 right now?
I think it's anybody born after 85 or something.
Oh, really? I thought it was anyway after 2000. What the fuck do I know?
No, no, no. It's like people who are in their 20s now.
Yeah, millennial. You know, that's the millennium. I don't fucking know.
I thought it was people born in... Ooh. In 95.
Well, yeah. It's like 85 and later.
Right.
Because that would make you...
30.
20... Oh, well, maybe I'm wrong. I don't freaking know. I don't care.
Yeah, fuck them. Right.
Yeah, I guess I don't either because I don't even know what it is.
Because there's Generation Y, and then there's something else, and there's Millennials, right?
I think I'm Generation X.
Yeah, we are. Yeah.
Yeah.
Look at these fucking Keystone Cops.
Surprised they're not falling out of a paddy wagon.
Oh, look at that shot. Man, I love it. No, the dog runs away. That's the best part.
Fuck yeah. He's like, see ya.
And the guy chases after him.
Yeah, he's like, I ain't dealing with this shit. Look how many different colors there are. Like blue, green, yellow.
Fuck.
Yeah, no real place would ever be lit like this.
Yeah, right?
Right.
Imagine going to a hospital or something and it's like, it looked like this. Like, who designed this place?
Yeah, it's got to be all set pieces. I mean, look at that. Come on.
How come they didn't make a lot of movies like that? Or did they?
No.
They're all Italian, I guess.
Yeah, Bava and Argento, and that's really it.
They did all this type of like wacky set thing?
Mm-hmm. Not all that much, but yeah. Like, Argento never did something to this extreme again.
No?
No, I mean, he did a little bit with others. He tried to with Inferno, but it wasn't the same. This is, like, Once in a lifetime.
This is as good as it gets?
Yeah. You notice that the flowers are behind her here?
Yeah, that's the entrance, right?
Yeah, the iris.
Uh-oh. Did your mole just move? Hello, yes, she's on to us. Yes, kill them all now. Kill them. Everyone. Every last one. Yes, purge, purge, purge.
That bitch of an American girl.
Yeah, she ruined it.
And why the fuck does she go swimming with her shirt on? I mean, come on. Yeah. We've been looking at this girl all movie. She's cute. Let's get some fucking skin. Nope. She's going to go in there with a shirt on.
Ooh, look at those.
Fucking cold in there.
Party hat.
I guess she didn't pack a bathing suit or something.
We have no suits.
Yeah.
Oh, you killed it, Dave. I was trying my best not to say anything.
No Friday.
Oh. We can only go so long. Yeah.
I know. Just can't do it, huh?
Well, look at it this way. No suits. This is the only place we can do it. We can't do it in life. We can't do it at our jobs, with our parents, with our wives. This is where we can do it, so it just comes naturally.
Yeah.
So it's never going to stop. Anyone that's listening, just...
Deal with it. Tough shit.
Holy shit, Montgomery just got on the line. Holy fuck. Montgomery, what's up? Tough shit.
I don't give a fuck. Deal with it.
Oh, I listened to that the other day. I listened to the Bananiversary show for the first time since we did it. Oh, man. The Montgomery.
That was like 5 hours long?
Yeah, I didn't even finish it. I gotta finish it. But
now, explain this again. What don't I understand? The Bananiversary is not the show where we did The Shining?
That was the first anniversary, and this Bananiversary was the second.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, see? The term Bananiversary wasn't coined yet.
Right.
When is our third one supposed to happen?
We've missed it. That would have been June of last year.
Yeah.
If we weren't doing this in that time?
No.
Were we back in June?
No, we came back in September.
Oh, wow.
Okay, so we were still split. So maybe next year, if we're doing something, we could have a fourth Bananiversary.
Right.
It'll be 10 hours long.
This time we'll really rent a hall.
Yeah.
We'll have people there in the audience. It'll be amazing.
I can wear my tuxedo shirt.
Yes. Yeah. Yep. We'll get Mahoney there. We'll get Montgomery there. We'll have the Myers fan, you know, our old friends.
Is that guy still alive?
He's still making videos. I saw one by accident Myers just today.
Really?
Yeah, because I watched that video, the Banana Laser Sucks video. That's how this whole thing got started. That's why I wanted to watch the, out of nowhere, I thought about that video that he made. Because it's really hysterical, and I haven't thought about it in a while. So I played it on YouTube. About 2 weeks ago. And then after, I was like, oh, man. Then we took that and we did the Stand By Me skit using the stuff that he did in this video. So then I wanted to hear that, and that's why I started on Bananiversary. So on YouTube, when you watch somebody's video recently, it has the memory of, you know, I didn't subscribe to him, but I played his video. So because he posted a new video like 4 days ago, when I went on YouTube today, it was there. And it said, Q&A with the Myers fan.
Oh, my God.
Oh, boy.
Is it all the same old crap as usual?
I didn't listen, of course. Maybe I will now.
Yeah, let's see if you got any better.
I don't know. Oh, shit. It really, though, that shit is hysterical. Go back and listen to that video. That Banana Laser Sucks. It is so... That's why I made that video about... pardon me. I made that post in the Skeleton Crew about Jamie baking the cake, the Jason Burris.
Oh, yeah, that's where you got the idea.
Yeah, it's so fucking funny. It's comedy gold now. It really is.
Yeah.
There's probably people listening to this commentary that have no fucking idea what we're talking about.
I know. We do a lot of things where you actually have to be like a regular of this show to understand it, but whatever.
Right. Anyone that
pay me, I'm going to keep doing that.
Exactly. Fuck you, pay me. Right. But seriously, go back and listen to Banana Laser from episode 1 and listen to Skeletal Crew from episode 1. You'll get every fucking reference we say. You'll appreciate the shows.
It'll only take you 800 hours, but you'll get this one.
Well, it took Jerry Herring like fucking, I don't know, 5 days to go through all the Skeleton Crew shows.
Jesus Christ. What, do you have a vacation that you needed to fill?
I think he's at show 86 now, right, at this moment.
Oh, he's almost at the big one.
Yeah.
The Gretzky.
Hmm.
Wake up, little girl.
Yeah, can you take off your shirt? I want to see something.
Not to be. Now she'll do it. Now she's going to be in the remake. Now she'll fucking probably show skin.
Yeah. Now, like, wait, when is the Blu-ray for this coming out?
Oh, don't start. I don't fucking...
Is it really still an issue? Oh, my God.
Yeah. They're taking their sweet time.
Yeah.
What, are they examining every frame of film?
Yeah.
Jeez.
Probably.
It'll be worth it. They're giving it the respect it deserves. I'm just tired of fucking waiting. Well, hold on. The 4K just came out. They re-released it for the anniversary. And it came and played at some theaters. But not the Blu-ray yet. But that's a start. They have a restoration done. Why do I gotta live in fucking Buffalo where I can't go to the movies and see it? Man.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, you know. Well,
yeah.
Which. Okay, guys. So, what's the implication? Do you think that she can't see? Like, here, we're just being shown blue because, you know, for the viewer's sake, that she can't see what the fuck's going on.
Yeah, it's supposed to be, yeah, absolutely pitch black.
That's because otherwise, it makes this part here make a hell of a lot more sense when she does the jump that she can't really see what she's gotten herself into.
Hmm.
You'll see. In case you don't know what I'm talking about, it's coming now.
Yeah, I only saw this movie once.
Damn.
You know, it's funny, one of my favorite artists who do soundtrack is, oh, hold on. I don't want to distract from her screaming.
This is scary.
Yeah.
This is like Jalo part right here, you know?
Yeah. Which I prefer the Giallos to this, although this is a great film.
You would rather watch, like, Cat of Nine Tails than Suspiria?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
I just love the whole POV stuff, the slashing with knives, the wearing the gloves aesthetic. I just love that so much.
Do you ever see Bird with a Crystal Plumage?
Mm-hmm. Yep. The bird that flew over the crystal plumage? Yeah.
Well, I was going to say, in fear.
Yeah. One of my favorite guys, like groups who do soundtracks for movies, is a really great group called Nilbog. They're really good.
Nilbog.
It's Goblin Backwards.
For a second, I thought you were talking about the guy that did the original Skeleton Crew song. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, remember that?
I love it. Rabbit in Blue.
You're Rabbit listening to Rabbit in Blue with the Skeleton Crew.
Awesome.
The music stops here, and it seems, I don't know, strange.
The day the music stopped.
I wouldn't go out there. It's like a room full of razor wire.
Well, see, that's what I was getting at. Can she not see this? Are we just shown this as a viewer? Because why would she jump into it?
And also, who has a room full of razor wire?
Hey, you know, witches.
I mean, don't get me wrong, it's cool, but it's just like, it's like in Wayne's World where he's like, I just always want to open a door where there's guys training and fighting. Makes no sense.
They got tons of weapons here. They got all kinds of shit.
Yeah, but is this? I'm pretty sure this is not how you store razor wire. Like, just throw it. Yeah, just throw it in that room right there. Yep. Done.
My guess is that she's not the first person to venture into this. That, you know, the witches have this here for a reason.
Gotcha, bitch.
Yeah.
Slinky, it's Slinky. That's gotta hurt.
Fuck.
Dude, first off, stop moving so much, and then carefully plan your escape. It's like all this just constant wriggling is going to make it worse.
Yeah, it's like quicksand.
Yeah. She's overcome with fear.
Oh.
That's pretty good.
Man. Fucking A, so cool.
Pretty great.
No wooden hangers.
This is like the most normal lit. Oh, nope, there's red. Never mind.
Yeah, it didn't take long.
Yeah, Roy, the ambulance driver, picked her up.
Do you guys think that there's an overuse of these types of colors? Do you think they're... that he should have backed off on a couple scenes or whatever, or is it okay?
No, it's not overwhelming to me.
Right. Not like, to me. Did you ever notice it. When it's not like that, then there's something, like the wall is red or something? Like, there's always something like that, even if it's not lighting.
Right.
It'll be the actual wall or whatever, or the windows.
I guess to certain viewers, it could seem jarring. I could see that.
Yeah.
Not to me. I mean, I love that aesthetic, but it's not for everybody. But there always is something going on. You're right. It's like a nonstop fucking... You're right. It's constantly something jumping out at you one way or the other. I like her clothes.
Yeah, 70s.
Snakes.
Snakes. Snakes. I don't know no snakes.
See, this I don't get. They are both in the know as right. to what happened to that girl. Why are they having that conversation? Unless they're doing it for the sake of Susie, who's below.
Yeah, they know she's down there, I believe.
That must be it. And here's the narrative for 5 minutes. This explains this the guy. Whole movie. This yeah. whole thing, him and Udo Kier, the whole fucking 5 minutes here is just narrative to explain what the fuck's going on here.
It's funny to see him so young because I only know him as, you know, as he is kind of now and, you know, 10 years ago.
Yeah.
He should just shoot this girl in the ass with a slingshot.
Yeah, he does kind of look like him.
Is that a palm tree?
No.
No, it's not.
Tom Six was going to use this guy in Human Centipede 3 if that doctor didn't want to come back.
Was he really?
That's true, yeah. It's true.
Yeah, I believe it. Because he kind of does resemble him.
Mm-hmm.
And he got those eyes.
He can play him like he did. This is like the most subdued he's ever been on film, I think. He's usually fucking crazy.
Right.
Let me bring this gentleman over. He can explain the rest of the movie.
Yeah, it's great.
I got to get out of here.
It's so funny
to see him outside drinking out of a glass. You know, like today it's like all water bottles and shit. It's like, where are you going to take that glass, dude?
You're right. You can't even have glasses outside at a lot of places.
Yeah.
Can you guys, where you're from, are you allowed to walk out of a bar with a bottle of beer or no?
No, not really.
Yeah, actually, in downtown St. Louis, you can totally do that.
Hmm. But not for you, Alex, no?
Well, I can't say I try, but I've never seen anybody do it.
We can't do it here. It's illegal.
I'm mainly thinking of when there's a Cardinals baseball game. You can just walk the streets with beer. I do that a lot after work. Wow. I grab a beer and walk to my car. Or I guess I used to. I don't really do it anymore.
It was really weird because when I moved to Vegas, I you know, out there you're allowed to do it. And it took me a while to get used to because in Buffalo you can't. You can't walk out of a bar with a bottle of beer or a glass or any, you know what I mean? But out there you can. So I was just curious about, you know, where you guys live, what the rule was.
This guy's going to explain the rest, because if I have five more lines, they have to pay me more than scale.
Right. That's how they got around it. Well, I guess we'll just bring in a different character then. Fuck you. I have to go finish my wine over there. They got a whole buffet over there. What the fuck is this?
Yeah, I don't know. What is this arrangement? Eh.
Really? I believe in warlocks, but not witches.
He looks like Billy Crystal's character, Neverending Story.
Have fun storming the cat. Wait a minute, wrong movie.
Oh, wait, wait, Bride? What movie am I thinking? Oh, Princess Bride. Wait, is that what I'm thinking of? Oh, yeah, right.
I was thinking, what? Neverending Story. Billy Crystal was in that movie.
Yeah, he was the rock giant or whatever.
He was the dog.
Oh, yeah. He played the nothing.
Right. If you guys ever have the unfortunate experience to watch part two of Neverending Story, you guys see the mockery they make of the rock guy.
No. Yeah, I've watched part of it. It's atrocious.
No.
And what's a shame is that it's literally the second half of the first book. Like, that movie is all inside of the same book that the first movie is based off of. It's just they fucked it all up.
I'll tell you what. I never watched that movie because it never made sense. If something's called The Neverending Story, why would there need to be a sequel?
It never ends.
It never ends.
That's what I'm saying. It's like, what do you call it? The Last Exorcism Part 2. It goes along those lines. You know?
It's an amazing fantasy film. It really is.
Part 2?
Oh, no. No.
Oh, okay. Okay. Exactly.
Okay, you've seen it. Okay.
Hey, so if it's called that, you know.
What name does he yell out at the end?
It's like The Last Exorcism Part 2 kind of thing. Yeah, I don't think that you're supposed to know what name it is. It drove me insane as a child.
No one ever... It never was revealed? There never was an actual answer?
I don't think so. I think I looked into it at one point. I've forgotten. I think when you read in the book, it doesn't tell you.
It says inaudible scream?
Probably. Yeah. I think it's wine.
Yep. I think maybe it's Nilbog.
Nilbog?
Yeah.
Nilbog! I gotta watch that movie again.
No, you don't.
Yeah, you do. As long as you're on fucking cough medicine. Yes. And I was not talking about...
I don't think I watched
Troll.
The whole thing.
Troll 2 or Never Ending Story?
Well, I really meant Never Ending Story.
Good, I was hoping. Okay. There's no reason to watch Troll 2 at all.
Right. No. I couldn't make it through it.
Fuck Let's get the Blu-ray. You know what I like to do sometimes? I like to put it on during the scene where the girl is having that horrendous, like, monologue with her boyfriend. And she's doing that really bad, like, he would cut your itty-bitty balls off and stuff like that. I like to just have that playing when people come over my house so they think I'm, like, I just act like I'm watching a normal movie and I don't react to how bad it is. I just want to see what they think about it.
That'd be funny.
Hello.
Hello.
Peter! Hello!
Peter!
Hey. Producer,
do a commentary on Black Christmas.
Is that Jason's toilet?
Is that cum?
Oh, yep, it is.
That was a fucking, what do you call it? Abortion.
Oh my god, there's the abortion.
Yeah, that's gross.
Oh, things still...
Shitbox is gross.
Now that's gotta be
crazy
Pete.
On Friday.
Right?
That was the wine, I think.
Yeah, but how could that be wine? Would wine
yeah,
do that?
There's no way. No. Right. Well, it will, but it's wine that's that color, like, come on. I don't know.
No.
Yeah, that's one thing that's up.
I guess water goes clockwise down a drain in Italy, too. That's weird.
Oh, man, here you go, your favorite part.
Are those eyes or headlights?
This is my favorite part? Oh, yeah, that's right.
Yep, yeah. That's what you were waiting for.
Yeah, it's ridiculous.
Yeah.
Oh, a bat?
I love it, though. Well, why not a bat?
Yeah, it's... But this just goes on for so long.
It's so big.
Yeah.
It's the biggest bat ever. It's fucking huge.
Get off me. I'm getting tangled in the string. The funniest part is when it's on the floor and just, you know, like they didn't turn the batteries off, so it's still just doing the exact same thing. He just wants to give you kisses.
I want to see that bat. He does the opposite of the parakeet in Nightmare 2.
Right, yeah. See, he's still just going to town like a fucking, I don't know, like when you hit a June bug or something and it's on the ground just flapping its wings.
Okay, Terror Dome. The bat in Suspiria versus the parakeet in fucking Nightmare 2.
Oh.
Well, I'd say it's easily the parakeet because that at least has, you know, the explosion going on. It would take them both out. This bat doesn't do shit.
Yeah, but...
Gives lovin's to your face.
Yeah, but that was Jesse with his goddamn cherry bomb.
Oh, right. So, yeah, he has the parakeet as Jesse, too.
As an accomplice.
Be a good fight, though.
Mm-hmm.
A good fight.
Yeah, Superman versus Mighty Mouse, you know?
Yeah, I know.
Well, maybe if they fight, yeah. Maybe if they fought in a room with a leaky gas pipe, it'd be better.
Shut up, Vern.
Superman's a real guy. Mighty Mouse is a cartoon idiot.
The never-ending Stand By Me references that half the audience won't get.
One time Matt strung all those together. It was really cool just listening to them all.
An anniversary.
Is that when he... No, he did a special thing where it was all bits and skits.
Yeah, because then you don't have the audience reaction.
Splits and Skits Volume 2, maybe?
Yeah, I think it's in Volume 2, maybe, yeah. Probably, I don't know. It's in, there's three of them. So.
Oh, if there's three, it would have been the last one. So Volume 3.
Yeah, probably.
Volume 3. I gotta listen to that next. Shit.
Yeah, I gotta order those CDs. I have to order Volume 3.
Yeah, it costs $10.99.
We should sell them as a package. Splits and Skits 1-3, packaged up with the Skeleton Crew Hits Volume 1 and 2, and
oh yeah,
and Matt did music too. Remember, Matt? What was that called?
Oh yeah, he did
all the songs that were ever on.
Podcast soundtrack. Just yeah,
yeah.
Songs. From I tell you,
that's a hell of a box set for next Christmas, guys.
Yeah. We gotta take them offline first. Oh, the free versions are not available anymore for some reason.
Everyone's running to their computers right now.
I'll just download it now.
I didn't realize these had value. Hold on, let me do that with you.
Yeah.
That's the plan. We'll take them all off and we'll sell them next year.
Before they go back into the vault like Disney.
Yes. The horrorphilia vault.
We should just edit all those and never release the original like George Lucas.
Yeah, we'll fucking douchebag.
I got all the, I don't know if I told you guys, I got all the first three Star Wars in its original form on Blu-ray because someone had the film that was in the projections in the 70s and 80s of the movie theaters, and they pulled it right from there right to Blu-ray at 1080.
That's amazing.
Yeah. Like, there's pops and scratches and stuff, but it actually adds to the experience.
In about 3 minutes, this film is going to get significantly less terrifying.
Oh, yeah, really? Are we at the end?
Yeah.
We're at 15 minutes, and this is the last 12 are
really
not as terrifying as the 92 that precede them.
What's great actually tagline, morons.
Let's actually focus and see if it gets worse in 3 minutes.
Well, Dave would probably say yes. You kind of already alluded to that.
Oh, yeah. He said it's an easy kill.
Yeah.
I do love it now, though. Now I look forward to it, where once upon a time I was a little let down with the ease. But I love it now. Because when she gets to that room and there's that fucking crazy looking, that peacock and shit. Oh, that shit's amazing.
Yeah, it's cool. Mm-hmm. I do
now,
like it.
Who are we looking at when we see this thing? Is it the Wizard of Oz looking lady I mentioned, or is it someone else?
Someone else. We haven't actually seen the character.
Okay. We've only heard her. Right.
Wow. They managed to find someone else who's almost equally as ugly as that lady to work in the kitchen with her.
And you two will be in the back. Yeah, yeah. You're definitely not, you know, going to be up front working with people.
Yeah. If you saw who prepared your food, you would stop going out to eat.
Totally. Fucking degenerates.
Yeah.
Take it from the chef.
Yep. Yeah, Matt knows, man. He hires these fucking people.
Oh, God, trolls all around.
Yeah, they're all sober, too, because they got to pass the drug test.
Kristen, better learn to cook.
Yeah, sure, sure.
Yeah, because they don't do coke at all in that food industry. Culinary art.
Let's see. The countdown is on, 12 minutes and 47 seconds.
I can't tell if the camera's moving or the friggin' background's moving.
Yeah, that's
what am I looking good at?
That's probably what he went for.
It's fucking cool.
Is it moving or is it me?
No, the camera's moving.
Okay.
Hey, the room is getting smaller. No, it's not. He's getting bigger.
Oh, well, that's not weird then. That Willy Wonka's growing as he walks away.
Right. Imagine if he was getting bigger. That would have been amazing.
They should have like a penis at the bottom one here as a joke.
A dick and balls.
Yeah. That'd be like in Scary Movie. The only thing is, nobody would get that fucking reference. Just us.
12 minutes. We're right now going to get less suspense.
I am not terrified. That's true.
Oh, good. Now my heart could go back to its normal beat
pattern. Yep. The terror has decreased immediately.
I feel like I remember this.
This is the reveal.
Turn the blue one. Man, it's insane to do an extreme close-up on a mouth that you've dubbed. That right? Really doesn't match up.
Extreme close-up!
Whoa! Whoa! Uh-oh.
I'll tell you this.
Ones and twos.
I will have that in my house. I'm going to get the three irises and then the blue one's able to be turned. I'll do that.
Whoa. Are you going to have like a sex den back there?
Yep, and a drug den.
Wow. You should have an opiate den.
I will. Sounds
good.
You
ever see those guys who hang out in the opiate den?
The opiate den, huh?
Or the, is that what they're called when they're all in the, like, the beds and stuff? It's like a bunch of bunk beds. And
yeah, they're all addicted to...
Opium.
Yeah, opium. That's good shit.
Yeah.
Slopium.
Yeah.
Nope, bad tagline, because this shit's good.
Yeah. Can we get to the reveal? Yeah, but I think...
I just weren't expecting you to analyze the tagline that much.
I think 5 of the 12 minutes are credits, though, right? So it's only 7 minutes of good stuff.
Yeah. Hey, you're probably right.
Actually, the way the credits come is amazing, and they're just, they come up at the very end, and then there's just like a minute of them, and it's
so fast. Yeah, it's like, oh really? Oh, it's over. Oh.
It's great. You have been watching Suspiria.
Hey, guys, what were we watching?
Yeah. Oh, I remember that, yeah.
In case you fell asleep and don't know where you are, you have been watching Suspiria.
In case you zoned out.
Was I watching Inferno? So this witch, she just lays in bed all day?
She's old and weak. That's really all she can do. She was weakened before by somebody else. So there's a whole fucking story.
Oh, I need the prequel.
Now that's what I wish they would do with this remake that's coming out. Take the three witches and explain what that guy was saying earlier, but show it to us. You know how they came and how they came into power, and they split in three different houses and the whole nine. That would make the remake worthwhile. So hopefully, maybe they'll do that.
I'm willing to bet. I doubt it.
I know. But Jessica Harper is going to be in it, so maybe she is going to play one of the three mothers.
Oh, that would be awesome.
Mm-hmm.
Understand. Yes, my lord. Chewing gum? Spearmint or fruit?
Fruit, please.
The Buxtons are not thieves, Pee-wee.
Look at that fat gold chain. She's like an EPMD or something.
Oh, shit.
Dario, there's something wrong with the lights. Just keep filming!
It's funny because she says, give me power. And then right after that, that's when that shit happens. I need more power for these lights.
She's drinking Powerade?
Fucking Dutch
I'm
boy.
I'm late for my pod race, please. Oh, shit. Yeah, I forgot whenever they showed the knife that there was those two pins, too.
Damn.
That's fucked up.
Yeah.
So, what are they doing with her? Just hiding her? Oh, they're going to resurrect her. Got it.
Resurrect him.
Yep. Cigarette. Wow. A lighter with a timepiece.
Oh, he stole it. He stole it from her. From her, oh. Yeah. They talked about it earlier in the movie. He was looking at it.
Yeah, you should search the internet for one of these peacocks, Dave.
No shit.
How amazing would that be?
Fuck. Yeah, that's awesome.
So this is the mother of what?
This is the mother of sighs.
Okay. And then there's the mother of tears.
Yes.
And then what's the other one?
Hold on. Shit. I should know and I forgot. I just discussed because this.
The third one is the actual name of the movie, right?
Right.
Like Mother of Tears is in Inferno?
Correct. Mother of Tears is in Mother of Tears.
Oh, we're getting it backwards? Okay.
The third mother, yeah.
Well, let's see. Maybe it's snot. I'm trying to think. You sigh, you cry, you blow your nose. Is that mother of snot?
Elena Marcus.
I wish she pulled back the curtain and it was like that snake woman from A Golden Child with Eddie Murphy. Huh? She's still sitting there. Like, fuck. She needs to try a little harder.
Right?
Like, fuck.
The living dead!
Yeah, you just said that.
Why is she talking about herself in the third person?
Yeah. And here she is, the living dead. That's fucking awesome. I love that. Yeah, the tagline is totally false.
Right?
Whew, good thing you saw that.
That's it. Mother
makes
of
no
darkness.
Sense, but I like it. Oh. That's who, in Inferno?
Yes.
Mother of Darkness? Die, bitch. So she can die just like a regular mortal.
Apparently, if you stab her in the right spot in the moonlight, ooh.
Wow. Gnarly.
Yeah, it's fucked.
She had Pringles on her fingertips. Or not, bugles. Shit. Fucked it up.
I'm not going to laugh now.
Yeah.
Bugles. I did the right eight bugles.
They're terrible.
I love that.
Got you now, bitches. Oh, so they all reciprocally feel the same thing?
Well, to kill a coven, if you kill the head, you kill the coven.
Oh, kill the head, the body must die.
It's like the head vampire. If you kill that one, they all die.
Uh-huh.
There you go.
And it's not Kiefer. It's that other dude, the video store owner.
This American bitch ruined everything.
Run, bitch, run. Whoa, doors are exploding open.
Yeah, get the fuck out. Damn.
You just got to get out.
Turn the blue one.
Yeah, that'd be amazing if she was leaving and another student was coming and like the same shit was happening.
Is this the Mina Marcos Dance Academy?
Yeah. Excuse me, can I come in? Go away! The building is on fire! No, I'm supposed to be here. I've traveled all day, god damn it.
But I've come such a long way, please let me in.
And there you go.
How? Yeah, and then the building is inexplicably on fire. Well, I guess all the shit was just falling apart, so.
Yep. Back to the rain, just the way we began.
Hey, guys, what have we been watching?
Yeah. I forgot the name of this. This is good. We should tell people about it.
That sound right there is my favorite music cue, and it's like only right there. Whine, 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 whine. Yeah, it's cool.
It's great.
Well, Dave, we did it. Sort of.
Yeah. We should review this abilities. Now.
Yeah, yeah. Let's spend 2.5 hours now breaking it down.
That's what we do with our life. It's so funny.
Break it down.
Francesca.
Man, I've got a funny feeling there's going to be no funny names here. Because I can't pronounce any of them.
Corrado. Like Corrado Soprano. Wow. I can pronounce every one of them.
You Italian Maurizio
Goroni.
Bertella Silvestri.
Mm-hmm. Anna Mode. Your last name's Mode? Fuck out
Modi.
Here.
Modi.
Oh, you're right. Okay, Modi. So thanks for watching or listening to the our Banana Waves Commentary Suspiria. Come back next time for a new one or something. Banana Waiter.
Bitch.
Banana Laser wins every time.